taking a break from my editing to do my photo of the day. The light hasn't quite moved in the house the way I'd hoped it would, so I'm going to work on the table behind me, and first I need to clear it off and get everything set up. This is going okay, but it's getting dark on the left side, so I am going to bring in an extra light to try to even all that up. So what is going on now is I've pretty much lost all of the outside light, so I'm going to switch things up and try to go for a very dark background instead of what I was hoping for, a very light background. What I was going for, but in with a black background instead of a white one that I was originally wanting. So I am going to call that my first photo of the year. It's getting close to 10:30 at night, and I still haven't taken my picture yet. Today it was pretty rainy,
Not too cold though, but maybe a day that you'd want to be cozy. So I thought that I would try to photograph a warm, cozy beverage. I finished editing the wedding that I had late December, December 21st, and took a little bit longer this time to get those edited than normal since I had a couple of busy days right after the wedding and then the holidays too. My goal wasn't really making these videos about photography so much as just making them about photography within my daily life. So it is just past 11, and I hope my nails have dried enough for me to start setting up for the photo and not mess them up. To do a test setup first before I actually go and make the hot chocolate, just to make sure I have all the settings right so I'm not actually experimenting while I'm trying to make the actual photo. I think I've got the flash set up and the camera settings, but I need to borrow this for a while so I can actually see what I am photographing, because unfortunately, even if I flip up the screen, I still can't see it with all this on top. A couple of more things still needed adjusting. First of all, I needed to add a lot more liquid into the cup. It needed to be about full so I could actually see what was inside. I needed to raise the tripod a bit. I needed to squat down. And then I was basically trying through looking at the phone preview to see if I was holding it where the focus was set, because I had set it to be just the right distance to fit this whole cup in. And then I had to just step on this remote to take the picture. That whole process of adjusting myself and adjusting the camera probably took 10 minutes. But I think it's successful. I think it looks good. It's still gonna need some work, some post-work to make it more dreamy, what I have in mind, but it's a good start. So with that, I think I might actually now have some of the hot chocolate that I made. So it is just past 2:30. I am just getting the day going. Today, I am gonna just pretty much take it easy and be on my own time, do a lot of housework. On days when my schedule is more my own, I usually make a bigger deal out of breakfast than just toast and some citrus. So that's what I'm going to do today, and I think that will probably be what I'm going to photograph as my picture of the day. It is so dark that I've got to use a very high ISO, higher than I would like, to take this picture, but I really can't recreate this light with flash. But I think it'll still get a good result. Thank you. So I'm not really sure what I want to photograph today. I don't really have a plan. It might just be one of those days where I'm just always on the lookout for something interesting. A couple of things I need to do today. I still need to finish up on some laundry. I have some digital organizing to do, stuff that I like to take care of on my downtime because I don't have much time to do it otherwise. So I'll just have to see what the day brings today. Okay, I've decided what I'm going to do today, and that is going to involve tea and a package of butter cookies. I need the window light, so I need to do it now during the day. I don't need to be waiting until night falls like I have been doing. And I am going to arrange the butter cookies around the plate, and hopefully that will make a very nice, cute photo. Going to do is stand in a chair and take from directly above. I don't think I'll be able to see any steam from the hot tea, but if I do, that'll be a nice bonus. I took another picture from this angle pointing towards the light. I thought it also made maybe a nice secondary fallback picture, just something extra to have. And so now this Earl Grey Bella Luna black tea smells absolutely fabulous, and so do the butter cookies. So I think I might have a few of those. I was editing my photos from the past couple of days. I had an idea, but when I tried to set up that idea, it wasn't gonna work out right. But that actually led me to another option, which I really like. So I am gonna do that today. Okay, I think I can call that one done.
I'm just back now from helping a client with her photo prints. I went to go meet her and see where things weren't working for her, and we got all that taken care of. Today, I need to do some finalization on a custom USB for my other wedding client and get that sent out. That shouldn't take too long. But now I am going to get some breakfast on. I have my design done now. I think it turned out pretty well. I made this pattern based on the bride's pattern she had on her hand here. And here is the USB and how it will turn out. This will be all transparent. We'll just have a black engraving here. When I got this nail polish out again a few days ago from my photo, I actually really enjoyed the process of painting my nails. I thought it was very therapeutic in a way, very meditative. This is old Victoria's Secret nail polish. I forget exactly what year I got it, probably 2004. So when I pulled it out, I went to the website just to see what their nail polish and their packaging looked like today. It seems like they don't make any nail polish anymore. I thought that was neat. That seems like I have a bunch of vintage Victoria's Secret nail polish. So I thought that I would pick a different color and do a photo of all the polish lined up. Hello. I am done with this photo now. I have been probably setting it up and working with it for maybe an hour. A little too much effort for the result of the photo, I felt. But once I started on an idea, I really wanted to get it finished. So let me take you through the setup. First, I had all these lights. I was hoping to be able to see them a bit more in the photo. That didn't quite turn out, and because it was a strand just fresh out of the box, they didn't want to stretch out very well, so I ended up using some hand weights and some glass back there to hold them up higher in the back so I could see that. And I have draped a black shirt over this chair because from the angle of my camera, I could not get rid of this white background. It was always in the picture, and I thought it was distracting. This is the tripod I usually have the phone on, but I needed to borrow it, and thankfully it's strong enough to hold this heavier camera. It's probably at its limit, though, for weight. Here's Here is my flash setup, but it's got a honeycomb on it to concentrate the light more, because I wanted it to be more like a spotlight, not a whole lot of fill. So let me show you how things ended up here. Here is the final photo. We have a shutter speed of 1/20th of a second, aperture of f4, and an ISO of 1250. Also, for the photo, I had the overhead lights off, so the only light was coming from the flash and from the string lights. Last night I was thinking I should probably be in my photos more, in the sense of a portrait, which I am not looking forward to, but that is what I'm going to try to do today. I have a window, I have a wall, I have my umbrella. There's no flash. I'm hoping that this will just bounce some light from the window this way. And I have the camera. I am also maybe hoping to include one of these goofballs in my picture. So I've set up the interval shooting, turned it on. I'm gonna let it wait 10 seconds for me to get in position. And I'll have it take a photo every 4 seconds, and I'll take 30 photos. I don't want it changing exposure much, so I've turned that to low. And I have turned off silent shooting because I want to know when it's taking photos. This is grayed out because I'm on manual mode. Very uncomfortable. Felt very awkward, not sure. I really had no idea what to do, but I hope I have something with the cats and me together. So now I get to put everything away. There is something I should probably do that I have been conveniently forgetting since the start of this month, and I should do it before the light goes. Thank you. so glad that that is done. It's not, I mean, it's a pretty luxurious crawl space as far as crawl spaces go, but still. Taking a break with my cup of tea for a bit, I think this should be my next task. It's been up for a good enough time, and it is time to head on into January and towards spring. Down the day, I'm going to make a quick smoothie and catch up on some TV. I hope you enjoyed following along with me this week as I made my photos, and I hope to see you back next week. Bye-bye!